You have so much going on with all of this. How are you coping?
It's become sort of the norm, but then again, every now and then I pull myself out and I'm like, is this really happening? It's scary.
I'm nervous about the doctor's appointment for Jazz. One of the major things we check are her testosterone levels, and it's supposed to be suppressed. And I'm always sweating. My palms are sweating till I get that number in.
This is fresh. We're the guinea pigs. Jazz is a guinea pig. But there are
other
people.
I don't like to think of it that way.
Yeah.
I don't know why you said that. That's not how I look at it.
Let's just say she's one of the newer kids of this generation that have done this. It makes my stomach churn, honestly, when I think about what she's going to have to go through. I don't talk to Jazz about surgery. It's one of those things that I sort of don't want to deal with and don't want to think about. And if she's not bringing it up, I don't want to talk about it. I know a friend of hers that had the surgery at 16. And we were, and Jazz
really?
Said,
Ed, is that allowed? I thought not.
There has been 16-year-olds.
We're coming through these teenage years, which are not easy years for any teenager. And she has all this extra stuff to deal with. She has to sort it out. She has to face the world one way, perhaps herself another.
I have been so proud of the way you've handled this. And you know,
it's not easy.
I can't even speak the right words, but just, you've got two proud parents here.
We've had exciting times, we've had difficult times, but through it all, we stuck together, and we know that at the end of the day, it's all about unconditional love.